Good morning, everybody. Today's topic is controllability. Now, what do we mean by controllability? It means that if any control input u can take all the state variables of a particular system from a desired initial point to a desired final point, then the system is said to be controllable. Otherwise, it is said to be uncontrollable. Okay? Means the control input u should be able to take all the state variables from initial value to a final value. Let's see a system whose signal flow graph is given like this. Here we have u is the control input and it has three state variables x1, x2 and x3. Okay, so u is connected, there is a link from u to x1, x2 and x3. Therefore, we can say that it can control x1, x2 and x3, all the three variables, the behavior of all the three variables. Now suppose even if there is one of the paths missing, for example this, if I say there is no link between this point and this point, something like this, so there is no link between these two points, so in this case the control input is able to control the behavior of the state variables x2 and x3. However, it is not be able to control the behavior of the state variable x1. Okay, so in this case, we can say that x1 is not controllable by u and the system is unstable. So, for a system to be stable or if I want to design the controller using pole placement method that we did in the previous class, my system should first be controllable, that is all the state variables of the system should be controllable. Now let's see how to check the controllability of the system. One of the methods is controllability by inspection. So for example, if I have a state space model of the system, x dot equals to ax plus bu, this is a and this is b. X dot is a vector, a 3 cross 1 matrix, x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. Let's find out the equations from here. x1 dot equals to minus a1 x1 plus u, x2 dot equals to minus a2 x2 plus u, x3 dot equals to minus 3 x3 plus u. So here we can see that all the three state variables can be controlled by the control input u. Therefore, the system is controllable. However, let's take another example. For example, this. Again, the state space model is given x dot equals to ax plus bu. Again, write down the state equations like x1 dot equals to minus a1 plus 0u. So, there is no u here. No control input. x2 dot equals to minus a5 x2 plus u. x3 dot equals to minus a6 x3 plus u. So from here we can see that x1 variable, state variable, is not controlled by the control input u. So the system is uncontrollable. So from here what I can see is that even if one of the rows of the matrix B, which I say as the input matrix or the coupling matrix B, have a zero value, that means my system is uncontrollable. Now this is not the sure shot method for defining the controllability of the system. Another better method is by defining the controllability matrix. Now let's first define the controllability matrix. For a system, for example, we have x dot equals to ax plus bu. Let's say it is the order of the system is n. Now how do I define the controllability matrix? Controllability matrix is defined as a matrix with rows b, columns B, A, B, A square B, and so on till A raised to power n minus 1 into B. Now let's see how to define controllability. I have the controllability matrix. If the rank of the controllability matrix is equal to the order of the system, in this case n. So in this case, if the rank of the matrix CM is equal to n, then we say that the system is completely controllable. Let's see this with the help of an example. So this is the signal flow graph of a system. Let's first write down the state space model here. So state space model, let's say x1 dot is equals to minus 1 x1 plus x2 and 0 u, because u, there is no direct connection in control input and x1. So minus 1 1 0. X2 dot is equals to minus 2 x2, so 0 minus 1 0 plus u, so 1. And x3 dot equals to minus 2 x3 plus u, so 0 0 minus 2 x and 1 u. Now let's find out the controllability matrix. So from the first of all, from here, since this B matrix has one of the rows as 0, by controllability, by inspection, we can say that the system is uncontrollable. Now let's see what happens if I define the controllability matrix. Now this, since the order of the system is 3, the controllability matrix becomes B, AB, A square B, and the matrix is represented as this. Now what is the rank of controllability matrix? How to find out the rank? Rank is equals to the number of linearly independent rows or columns. Basically what it means is that the any two rows are not multiples of each other. Or also we can say that rank of a system is the highest order square submatrix whose determinant is not equal to 0, that is non-singular. So for example, here it is a 3 cross 3 matrix. If the determinant of this 3 cross 3 matrix is not equal to 0, then I say the rank of is equals to 3. If it is equals to 0, I will try to find out the rank of the submatrix, which is 2 cross 2. Okay. And if it is non-zero or if it is non-singular, then we say the rank of the system will be 2. Now let's find out the rank of this system. What is the determinant? Determinant of this controllability matrix is equals to minus 1. Now this is non-singular, this is not equal to 0, so we can say that the rank of the controllability matrix is equals to 3, so the system is controllable. Now how is it possible? Let's again go back to the signal flow graph. Here we can see, although there is no direct connection between u and state variable x1, the link is not broken. There is still a path between the control input u and state variable x1. So we can say that indirectly x1 is controlled by the control input u. Therefore, by using the method of controllability matrix, we are getting that the system is controllable. Now for example, if there was no link, was broken, suppose the link here, this link, if I break this link, so my B matrix will become, instead of 0 1 0, it will become 0 0 1. Okay, so something like this, 0 0 1. So now since the link between control input u and x2 is broken, that means the link, indirect link between control input u and the state variable x1, is also not there. Now the controllability matrix in this case, B, AB and A square B, A remains the same, B is changed to this, will become this. And if I find out the rank, or if I say C, these two are 0. So the determinant of 3 cross 3 is 0, determinant of 2 cross 2, if I find out, again 0, and 1 cross 1, is definitely it is non-zero. So we can say that the rank of controllability matrix CM is equals to 1, which is less than the order of the system, where in this case order of the system is 3, therefore the system is uncontrollable. So in today's lecture we studied about the controllability, what is controllability, how to define the controllability matrix, and two different methods of deciding the controllability of the system, that is controllability by inspection and controllability using the defining the controllability of the system by using controllability matrix. Thank you.